3 people and no fresh water, just a few drops. I squeeze it into a handkerchief, the one you got me for our anniversary. I squeeze out a few drops. Nancy cries, "More water, Mommy." Hush, dear, Grandma needs a little water too.
Jesus.
The waves coming in. The boat's too heavy. We're sinking.
Life jackets.
No life jackets. You forgot to bring them. We're sinking. Too heavy. Somebody has to go overboard for the good of the others. What do you do?
Can they sight land?
We can't sight land. We're 500 miles from land. What do you do? Somebody has to go. What choice do you make?
We bail. We pitch in, and we all...
All right, bail, bail. Faster, faster. The water... It's coming in too fast. Nancy's hands are tired. She cries, "Daddy, I'm tired. Hold me, Daddy. Save me, Daddy."
I bail faster. I bail all the water out of the goddamn...
Washed away. The bailing can is washed right out of your hand. Gone. "Help me, Daddy. I'm afraid," she's saying. "Choose, Daddy. Please, make the decision. Choose. Wife, daughter, or... mother."
"Where's your mother?"
"We'll do my mother later. Choose! The waves are getting higher. The water's cold. The wind! Choose, choose."
"Why are you doing this?"
"We're doing this to find out. Like we said, we'd find out. All right, you agreed, so finish the game. The waves are crushing, breaking, smashing. The gull's screaming. The wind! Nancy's crying. Help me, Dad!
Stop saying Nancy's crying. Stop trying to influence me."
"Well, I'd be crying too. We're bravely trying not to cry. I take Nancy in my arms. Don't worry, baby. Daddy will find a way."
"Stop telling me what everybody's saying. Stop trying to sway me."
"Sway you? Your wife and daughter are drowning and you..."
"All right! And what is my mother saying? Let's have it all."
"Oh, she's not saying anything. She doesn't have to say anything. She feels secure. She knows she's staying in the boat."
"If she knows she's staying in the boat, why make me..."
"She thinks she's staying in the boat. Nobody knows for sure. You're the one that knows. You have to decide." "No."
"I can't. Okay, I can't.
If she all dies, I would too want for all of us to drown."
"I don't want anybody to drown. I didn't even want to play this jump."
"Save two of us. And two. But choose."
"I. Me. I go overboard. I drown, okay? Everybody's happy. I drown."
"You can't. You're needed to navigate. You're needed for navigation. You're the only one strong enough to throw one of us overboard."
"Why do I have to choose?"
"These are your people. We're all yours. Your wife, your daughter, your mother. We're all tied together through you. You have to decide now! Now! Before we're all dead and drowned! Just sightless, lifeless, bloated corpses floating to the bottom of the cruel and stormy sea!
Okay? You want me to save my mother. You want me to throw her into the sea. You do. You want me to visualize throwing my mother into the sea. You want her to drown.
Somebody has to drown. That's the situation. Somebody has to gurgle and clutch and scream. But who? Choose who?
Tell you what. My mother wouldn't let me choose. She'd jump over to save her grandchild.
And her son.
That's right.
And her daughter-in-law.
She jumped!
Suppose she doesn't jump.
She would!
She's not jumping. She's sitting there clinging to the side, clutching, drinking all the water, and eating the biscuits!
All by herself! She's the only one. You're not eating or drinking anything.
Okay, I'm eating too, and Nancy's eating. Do you mind that if Nancy and I have a sip of water and a bite of a soggy biscuit? Oh my God, there goes the biscuit! Another wave! Nancy, cover! Hang on! Hang on!
You're tearing my heart out!
What's supposed to tear?
Is that what you want to do? Tear me apart?
I want you to find out something. Admit something about yourself.
me go through with this? All for your fucking game!
Oh, come on, you're distraught.
Distraught? I'm just throwing my own mother overboard to save your fucking ass. I just drowned my own mother in the fucking sea. All for your fucking game. Her clutching hand going down, screaming, gurgling with her last breath.
I love you all.
Yes, all.
You too, Jen. I love you too.
Are you happy now? Are you? You are. You're happy.
Happy. I just watched my own mother-in-law drown. It wasn't easy, but it had to be done. It taught you something about your priorities. You understand something now. You've explored your feelings for your mother and for me and for Nancy. You said something beautiful. My mother. I'll drown my mother. That's horrible, but it's beautiful.
Mama! Mama!
Sea's quieting now. Sky's clear. Bright blue. Oh, we sail into a bright sunset. The three of us. Smooth sailing.
Mama! Mama! I just threw my own mother.
But she didn't know it. It was under the seat so that Nancy could live and she could have her mama and her daddy.
Sightless, lifeless, bloated.
Sherwin.
Floating down. Hair spreading on the water. Eyes scary.
It's past. The sea is quiet. And there!
Where?
There! An island paradise. Clear skies, palm trees, gentle seas.
Gentle seas?
And a happy family, sailing home to port.
Happy family?
Yes, warm breezes.
Sailing home?
To port. A man, his wife, and his daughter brought closer together by him. Tragic experience.
Closer together.
Yes. Calm, quiet seas. Warm, balmy breeze. Bright, clear skies. But wait. What's that?
Huh?
On the horizon. That black spot.
What?
Growing larger and larger. It's another typhoon.
No!
Just enough for two people now.